Standing in a circle. How many of you have heard that expression before? Yeah, so that was a one of the first katas for grasping the current condition. Teichiono, many of you know, that was a practice that he would have of drawing a circle on the floor and having the student stand
and observe the condition.
Thank you. Yes.
So, you know, as Mike was talking earlier about some of the observable things that people saw when they went to Toyota, one of those was, a circle. Let's draw a circle and have people stand in it. So for some of you who have learned from lean teachers, that was a practice that they used. Draw a circle and stand in it. So my experience was, okay, I'll stand in the circle. Here I am. And then the coach would come back and say, hey, what did you see? What did you learn? Well, I think maybe Bob and Betty are going out now. John got a new tractor, and Dave, I think he's a little ticked off at something. He's got something going on here that isn't good. So standing in the circle, not a lot of detail to what the kata or pattern should be for grasping the current condition. A lot of us muddled through that to figure out what would be some patterns or techniques that we could use to do it. But having a starter kata or pattern for grasping the current condition really is a great catalyst or platform to develop faster learning for those we're trying to teach. So here we are with our step two. So we've established the direction or challenge, and now it's time to grasp the current condition. You know, one of the things that I think of with grasping the current condition is it's not quite like the others. Mike mentioned earlier, too, that so certainly setting a direction or a vision, you know, it's a very exciting thing to do. And a target condition, that's setting a short-term objective on the way toward the challenge. And experimenting, come on. I mean, that's what we all want to do anyway, is experiment. So sometimes I think when we grasp the current condition that it's a little different than the others, right? But let's not make the mistake that grasping the current condition is anything but a superhero on your path towards achieving your challenges. So here we are, we're still in the planning phase, grasping the current condition. We've established the challenge, now we got to figure out where we are right now. So what's the purpose of grasping the current condition? Well, certainly, you know, one of the key purposes is that we want to understand the current performance and operating pattern that exists so that we can understand expand our knowledge threshold. That's really what we want to do at this phase. One of the more perhaps contentious points is it's really not about finding wastes. It's really not about finding wastes. As those who learned lean, you know, many years ago, that was one of the exciting points about, hey, I'm going to go grasp a current condition because we're going to go on a waste walk. That's not the purpose at this point. It's really to understand what's happening today, what's the current pattern, and it's like, you know, planning a trip. You know, here we are, our challenge is that we want to get to Atlanta. Well, where are we now? What's our capability of getting there? What methods do we have currently? What's our fuel level look like? Who's coming with us? And that may have bearings on things like, well, Aunt B's coming with us. Well, how's the batteries on my noise-canceling headphones? Or maybe, where's my Valium? You know, those kinds of things. But how do we grasp the current condition? Well, somewhat it depends. It depends on what level of the organization we're flying at here. So certainly here we can see that at the organizational level, grasping the current condition could look like things like understanding the market dynamics, understanding our competitors, understanding different elements of the current condition of our business, what's our current outcomes. At the value stream level, we have a great kata for that. One of those is the current state value stream mapping, which Mike and John Shook provided some direction for us at with Learning to See. But that is a kata or a pattern at the value stream level for understanding the current condition. But what about at the process level? So more detailed than just standing in a circle, what does that look like for us? Well, we have a pattern for that. There's a lot of detail around that in the practice guide. But certainly looking at the steps of that process analysis, what is our outcome? What is our current performance over time? What is the level of customer demand, planned cycle time? What frequency of the process, how does that look like? What are characteristics of the process? developing a block diagram, measuring exit cycles. What's our equipment capacity? What's our operator capacity? These are different starter patterns for how to understand the current condition that can really set and frame where we are today so that we can set that that first target condition for where we want to be in a shorter period of time. So my example. I've had a number of leadership roles within the healthcare organization that I worked with. Before I left about a year and a half ago, was vice president of perioperative services. That's the surgical arena. So what we did to understand the current condition of my area of responsibility was to go through and do value stream mapping. We wanted to understand what is the current end-to-end process flow from really supplier to customer about how we deliver care through surgery. And then you can see in the bottom down there certainly some elements of our future state map that helped guide us. So that led us to the point of an area that's little known within surgery, not talked about a whole lot, which is called sterile processing. So sterile processing is where we clean the instruments. We reuse instruments. They're expensive. They're very specialized, so we don't buy new ones every time. But it's important, as you can imagine, that we want to make sure that the instruments are clean from one case to the next. So think of it like washing your dishes. So we have an initial rinse process. We hand wash it. In sterile processing, we actually hand wash it and then machine wash it and then package it and then cook it to make sure it's sterilized. So just similar practices, if we were to observe the current condition of the patterns of behavior at my house with washing the dishes, we would see after we eat the kids running off, trying to hide after we eat so that they don't have to do anything. We would see the dishes just sit there and that the crust forms on the dishes so that you have to scrub it, pull out the grinder to get the debris off, and then put it in the dishwasher. But with at home, if you got a little debris left after washing the dishes, no big deal. In surgery, a little debris on an instrument is a huge deal. At best, if you identify that there's a piece of debris on an instrument when you're opening up the case for surgery, you rip down the whole room and start over again with all new instruments, everything. At worst, a patient gets a surgical site infection, which could lead to catastrophe. So this is a really big deal of a process. So how did we use the starter kata and teach those managers who were in those areas to understand the current condition initially? Well, one was we had a grasp overall, okay, what is this sterile processing and understand it. So we just stepped back to understand the big picture. But then looking at our performance over time, what is the outcome? Well, we don't want contamination, so let's understand what the contamination level is. What's the customer demand? What is the pace in which looking at our overall instruments and the time that we have to figure out what is the pace of instrument washing that needs to occur? What does the flow look like? What are other conditions within as we observe around the number of operators and where they're at within the process and time? We could have looked at machine capacity, but worker capacity. So this was a starter pattern for us to begin our learning with. Now, were these the only things that we looked at? No. But by using the starter pattern, the starter kata, it allowed us to recognize different things. Like, okay, this is what the one worker's pattern looks like. What do others look like? Do we have variability amongst workers? Oh, do we have a standard in place? How are we training people to the practice of washing these instruments to make sure that we have consistency and not variability of how people are practicing? So that was one example of how we used the starter kata to begin our understanding of the current condition. It wasn't the end, but it was the beginning for us and a structured way for the learners to begin to use a consistent practice to understand the current condition of a process. But as we know, not all processes are created equally. And in healthcare, you know, we've got thousands of processes, as you probably do too. So something like communicating with patients. So we have something called hourly rounding, where a nurse or other caregivers come into the rooms on a regular basis, oftentimes hourly with a specific purpose or purposes. So how do we use that starter kata with a process that isn't quite continuous, like the one that I mentioned before with the washing? Well, let's ask the question. Let's look at the different categories and say, let's not first say, well, that's not going to work here. Let's recognize that, hey, let's try the pattern. What is the process? What is our outcome? Certainly, we do have an outcome of performance. What's the rate of customer demand? Well, we have a certain number of rooms. If we want to do it hourly, that gives us a sense of the pace of the work that needs to happen. And what does the shift look like as far as the number of hours of the day that we want to do rounding? Well, we want to do it for 24 hours a day. Not always a popular thing at 3 o'clock in the morning for that rounding, but still something that, for those of you in the hospital, we apologize, but that's part of a safety process to understand what's happening, what's the current condition within that room. What are the characteristics of the process? Well, there is a process flow. There's a cycle time for how rounds happen. There's other things that we can observe. How many people? What is the time it takes versus the pace needed to figure out, do we have the right number of people to complete the rounding, and other factors. So one of the things that we learned in looking at other processes is using the starter pattern for grasping the current condition is a good way to understand where we're at right now and for us to also know what do we need to learn next. But at least that starter pattern is what we would start with. And then from there, we could explore other elements of exploring the current condition. So grasping the current condition, some lessons learned over time with grasping the current condition. There are many, but one is, well, it's not about necessarily just standing in the circle and having, especially those new learners, just stand there and observe. Unless there's some entertainment value as you as a coach really want to get out of that by watching somebody struggle mightily with what that really means. But let's start with a starter kata. So look at the starter kata for grasping the current condition and begin practicing that and learn from practicing that starter kata. It's not the end-all be-all, as Mike said, but it's a starter pattern. As you adjust looking at other elements of your pattern for grasping the current condition, that's great. But still, for the new learner, have a pattern. Have a kata for them to make sure that they aren't just standing in the circle looking and you're hoping for them to have this big aha. We're really at a place where we can do better than that as far as guiding our learners. Use the challenge to guide your current condition. Knowing where we are right now is great, but it's in context, like Julie and Scott mentioned, of where we're going. It's very dependent on where we're going. So that can also help us frame what do we really need to understand about the current state based off of where we're going. If I'm going to Atlanta, well, it's a big deal to know that I'm in Appleton right now, Wisconsin, I'm in Marietta, which is just up the road. That's going to dictate a lot about what I need to understand about my current condition. What would the customer want you to notice? A lot of the processes that at least we have in healthcare and in education are very customer-facing. And just asking ourselves of what would the customer want to notice or what would the customer notice with regard to our current condition? Walk with the learner. What I mean by that is certainly we want to be teaching people a starter pattern, but it's more than just teaching them. It's walking with them. It's going to see with them initially about making sure TWI framework, we're not just telling people, but we're showing them, we're explaining them to them about the patterns that we're trying to have them follow with regard to grasping the current condition. And one other is grasping the social condition. Grasping the social condition, when we go to see, we need to appreciate that there's a technical thing that we're looking for and patterns, but also we're walking into an area that is full of emotion, full of history, about improvement. So respecting the fact that when we're grasping the current condition, we're in the gemba, we're in the work, so we need to respect where we are. And in acknowledging that, that's going to change the way that we behave as leaders when we're in the gemba. In closing, understanding the challenge and grasping the current condition positions us to better be able to set our first target condition. And one thing I just to keep thinking about is don't underestimate the magnet that is at the far end of the overall improvement kata, which is the experimentation that is pulling us there, that we need to slow down and grasp the current condition. That's really going to help position us to better understand where we are. It's going to help us set better target conditions to lead our experimentation. So, the one piece of advice I would have, follow the kata.